It is time now to talk Beach Week, and every day this week we're headed to a different beach in Rhode Island, scoping out the fun to be had in the sun this season. Now today we're checking out Misquamicut State Beach in Westerly. That's where Will is there right now. He is live enjoying the day in the Ocean State. Will, I'm jealous of you, buddy.
Let me tell you, you know, I know it's foggy out. I know you can see the fog behind me. But if you're sitting at home wondering what are you going to do during the summertime, come on down to Misquamicut. The waves are rolling in. Our toes are in the sand. It is a great location. I'm joined by this guy over here to my right, Caswell Cook. He's the director of the Misquamicut Business Association. Thanks for having us down here today.
Oh, well, thanks for being here, Misquamicut. Yeah, this will all burn off in a couple hours. I'm like the movie Jaws?
Yeah.
And the guy's like, there's sharks, but we don't say the word shark. I don't say the word rain. I'm the mayor. I think, you know, in that movie, I say, come on down no matter what.
We're going to hold you to that,
that's
by the
right.
way. You have had a busy few years after the storms that came through here down at Misquamicut and down here in Westerly. And really, you know, the place, it took a big hit, but it's great.
Everybody's back. It's crazy. Yesterday, we dedicated our new Town Beach Pavilion with Senator Reed and Senator Whitehouse, and that was really the last piece of the puzzle, and we're full bore.
Obviously, when that happens, I'm sure your heart sank. A lot of businesses, their heart sank. Now that you're back in business, it's got to be a great feeling to see all these businesses thriving, because we were also talking, business has been great.
It's great. I have a little restaurant down the street, and we did really well this weekend, which I think is indicative of the whole strip. It was more people than I had seen in a long time down here. I mean, 4th of July is always busy, but this was really busy.
This is really, for anyone who hasn't, I know Rhode Islanders are tough. Rhode Islanders are really tough. They need to pack like an overnight bag, you know, to come down here to Misquamicut. But this is one of these places that they really need to venture out to and come by and see.
They do. I mean, like later today, I'm going to Warwick, which is going to be a... No, I'm just joking. But no, it's like...
We're booking hotels for you now.
Misquamicut's got everything. It's a great day trip. And it's like Connecticut and Massachusetts discovered this place. We're the longest stretch of beach in Rhode Island. We want you to discover it. So come on Facebook, Misquamicut Beach or Misquamicut.org, and see all the events and activities we have going on.
All right, let's talk about some of the activities that are going on, because it's a busy place. There's plenty of parking down here for people. It's another concern for a lot of Rhode Islanders. Where am I going to park?
Yeah.
Where am I going to go? You've got that covered.
We do. The State Beach is one of the many parking places at the beach. From Paddy's down to the Windjammer Dunes Park, different rates, shop around. But we do on Monday and Wednesday nights at the Town Beach. We have concerts. Last night was John Ford Coley. We got John Cafferty coming up in a couple weeks. We have Thursday night drive-in movies. There's only two drive-ins in Rhode Island. We have one of them. We had Jaws last week. We're doing Jaws 2 this week. We got Goonies, great movies coming up Thursdays. Magic shows on Thursdays. We got classic car shows on Thursdays. Tuesday night, the Chamber of Commerce does kids movies on the beach. So hermit crab races on Wednesdays. So, I mean, every day of the week, there's something going on in Misquamicut, and the drive-in's just really taken off this year, too.
Your dance card is full down here at Misquamicut. Thanks again for having us down here. Caswell mentioned a little while ago, too, a couple of seconds ago, about the magicians. We are going to talk to them. We're going to show you some of the classic cars in just a little bit, too. Look, this is not a bad gig. There are worse places to be. Back to you.
Beach Week rolls on here on the Rhode Show with a trip to a beautiful beach in our area every day this week. Now, as we go about our busy lives here, it's important to enjoy this short summer season in New England. That's right, as Ferris Bueller would say, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. So let's check in with a big Ferris Bueller fan himself, Will Gilbert, who's out enjoying the gorgeous weather at Misquamicut Beach in Westerly. Hey, Will, have you run into Taylor Swift yet? Tell her I said hi.
You know what? Taylor Swift's house is that way. We're waiting for her to come. I wouldn't hold my breath on that. We are here at Misquamicut State Beach. Now, you know, we were talking with Caswell a little while ago, talking about all of the events that happen. They have magicians in a lot of these clubs. They've got classic cars. We're going to get to that. But first, we are talking to Larry Stengel. He's one of the magicians that performs during the week down here at Misquamicut.
That's correct. Thursday nights over at the Windjammer, right up the road.
All right. I was talking to you earlier. How long have you been doing magic?
A long time.
He said since he was 8 years old, just so everybody knows. All right, explain to us what's going to happen, because I did see you lock your friend David in that box behind you.
Yeah,
with the master locks.
He's in handcuffs, he's in a bag, and normally he's not in there this long, but I'm kind of enjoying this right now. It's quiet as he's been all day.
All right, so tell everyone what's going to happen. You're actually going to be able to switch positions, right?
Right, exactly. This is a trick that was made famous by Houdini back in the early 1900s. It's called metamorphosis, and
right.
This is our version of it.
Okay, all right, so you're ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
All right, my fingers are crossed that the poor guy's going to be able to get out of the box.
I hope so, too.
All right, I'm going to step back. All right.
Here we go. Are you ready? Don't anyone blink your eyes or you'll miss metamorphosis.
Hi-o!
Oh! That is good stuff.
Thank you.
Now, this is David, the other magician, who was in the box. I'm assuming Larry's in the box. Larry, are you in the box?
He's in the box. All good.
So everybody's good. How long have you been part of the magic act?
I started when I was about 4 years old, actually, doing magic. So it's been a really long time, and I'm enjoying it every single time.
And you're able to pick up chicks with magic. That's what I heard.
Doesn't hurt, that's for sure.
All right, thanks, guys, so much. We're going to move down here. John Hodes, MBA, Classic Car Show Coordinator. Nice. Thanks so much for coming out and bringing all of these fine folks. You said you love all of these people, and they are the backbone of everything.
They are the backbone of the beach on Thursdays, along with the magic show, the drive-in and everything that goes on. We run shows for the MBA here in the spring and the fall, and then, like I said, the cruise night right along. And we all have a good time.
John, talk about some of the cars, because they really are great-looking cars. These men and women take such great care, such great pride in all of the vehicles that are here today.
Yes, especially Don Wood's Dodge there. It's very, very unique in its sense. And we got Ronnie's coupe that's always here. And then we have Donald and Bob. And all these cars, they treat them like they're babies. You know, they're really, really, really meticulous on how they take care of them. But we have a good following down here. And on Thursday nights, we just have a lot of fun.
Not only, I mean, everybody knows everybody.
Yeah.
They really are part of the, like, a family together. You travel all over the place together and are out and about all of the time.
Yeah, we do a couple other cruise nights at different other locations, Pavilion, Okaba Village. And all these guys are right there. Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays.
Now, I'm sure some people at home, they may have one of these classic cars. They may go out to these events. If they want to be part of yours, what's the process? Do they have to go someplace to sign up? Or where can they get more information? Or can they just show up and hang out with you folks?
Well, on Thursday nights, they can run down here on the beach and just look for the car show lady over there on the gate and just drive in, park, and enjoy. A little ice cream, a little soda, maybe go on the merry-go-round, whatever. You know?
All right. Sounds good. Thanks so much for coming down. Thanks to all of these great folks out here with their classic cars that they take so much pride in each and every day. You see them driving around the road. We are having a great time down here at Misquamicut State Beach. We're going to take a plunge in just a little bit. Back to you.